In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. During these 6 weeks of Lent, we have been taking a journey. We have been trying to follow in the footsteps of Jesus, who spent time in the desert preparing to do his Father's work. Today, we will make the same journey Jesus did on his last day on earth, except we will look at it through his mother's eyes. We will experience her confusion, her helplessness, and her ever-present faith. I am Mary. It was early Friday morning when I saw my son. His bruised and bleeding skin sent a sword of pain deep into my heart. Tears rolled down my cheeks. Then Pilate, from his chair of judgment, asked the crowd why they wanted my son executed. All around me they shouted, "Crucify him!" I wanted to plead with them to stop, but I knew this had to be. So I stood by and cried, silently. Do I remain silent when I witness someone being wrongly accused? Do I judge others? I walked with the crowds to the entrance of the square. A door flew open and my son stumbled out. Two men dragged over a heavy wooden cross and dropped it on his shoulders. My pain for him was unbearable. I wanted to take the cross from him and carry it myself. But I knew this had to be. So I walked on, silently. Do I reach out to help those who are suffering or struggling in any way? Am I prepared to make decisions for the good of others, even though some may criticize me? I followed closely behind my son as he stumbled towards Calvary. I saw the cross digging into his shoulders. My heart dropped when I saw him fall face to the ground. For a moment, I thought my beloved son was dead. Then the guards kicked him. He rose slowly and began to walk, yet they still whipped him. I wanted to protect him. But I knew this had to be. So I walked on and wept, silently. Do I cause others to fall? Do people feel humiliated because of the way I treat them? I had managed to break through the crowd and was walking side by side with my son. I called to him through the shouting voices. He stopped. Our eyes met. Mine, full of tears and anguish. His, full of pain and confusion. I felt helpless. Then his eyes said to me, "Courage. There is a purpose for this." As he stumbled on, I knew he was right. So I followed and prayed silently. Do I make enough of an effort to help others through their suffering and distress? Do I help others with the burdens they carry? I could now see complete helplessness on the face of my son as he tried to carry his heavy load. Each step looked as if it would be his last. Then the guards pulled a protesting man from the crowd. They forced him to pick up the back of the cross and help lighten my son's load. He asked the guards why this had to be. I knew, so I followed silently. Do I need to be pushed a little to help others to carry their crosses? Am I willing to step out from the crowd? As I continued close by, a woman pushed past the guards, took off her veil, and began to wipe my son's sweating, bloody face. The guards immediately pulled her back. Her face seemed to say, "Why are you doing this to him?" I knew, so I walked on in faith, silently. Have I reached out to my neighbours, who may be hurt or grieving this year, and offered my support and words of encouragement? Again, my son fell. I started to move towards him, but the soldiers prevented me. He rose and stumbled ahead slowly. Seeing my son fall, get up again, and continue on was bitter anguish to me. But since I knew this had to be, I walked on, silently. When I stumble and fall, do I reach out for your love and help? I was walking a few steps behind Jesus when I saw him stop. Some women were there, crying for him and pitying him. He told them not to shed tears for him, but for themselves. Am I so absorbed in my own life that I am not aware of the needs of others whose lives are an uphill struggle? Not only had Jesus fallen on the rocky ground again, but now he was almost at the top of the hill of crucifixion. The soldiers screamed at him and abused him, almost dragging him the last few steps. My heart pounded as I imagined what they would do to him next. But I knew this had to be, so I climbed the hill behind him, silently. With my son finally relieved of the weight of the cross, I thought he would have a chance to rest. But the guards immediately started to rip his clothes off his blood-clotted skin. The sight of my son in such pain was unbearable. yet I knew this had to be. I stood by and cried silently. Do I inflict pain on others? Do I take away another person's dignity by what I say and do? As they threw Jesus on the cross, he willingly allowed himself to be nailed to it. As they punctured his hands and his feet, I felt the pain in my heart. Then they lifted up the cross. There he was, my son, whom I love so much, being scorned as he struggled for the last few moments of earthly life. But I knew this had to be. So I stood and prayed, silently. Why are innocent people today still experiencing the horrific pain Jesus experienced as he was nailed to the cross? What greater pain is there for a mother than to see her son die right before her eyes? I, who had brought this Saviour into the world and watched him grow, stood helplessly beneath his cross as he lowered his head and died. His earthly anguish was finished, but mine was greater than ever. Yet this had to be. I had to accept it, so I stood by and mourned silently. Am I willing to put the needs of others before my own? The crowd had gone, the noise had stopped. I stood quietly and looked up at the dead body of our Saviour, my son. The two men took the body from the cross and placed it in my arms. A deep sorrow engulfed my being. Yet I also felt deep joy. Life had cruelly ended for my son, but it had also brought life to us all. I knew this had to be, so I prayed silently. Do I treat others with respect and dignity when they are in sensitive situations?
Mother, behold thy
We brought Jesus' body to a tomb, and I arranged it there, silently weeping, silently rejoicing. I took one more look at my loving son and then walked out. They closed the tomb. I waited in faith, silently. Do I give up too easily on your love? Am I forgetful of your never-ending love? The tomb is empty. The darkness is over. Jesus is alive. He continues to work in the world today through each of us. This is the lasting joy and hope of the message of Easter. As we come to the end of our Lenten journey for 2023, remain with us and guide us. The light of the world is shining brightly. May we be filled with the hope and joy of knowing your presence in our lives and in the world today, tomorrow, and always. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.